center, right in the middle of the clock, and then unfold it, okay? That's step one. I don't use that so much. I like to roll it up. So I roll it onto my rolling pin, and then I bring the pie pan. Let's say this is my pie pan, okay? I bring my pie pan to me. Now, some people unravel away from them. I find that what happens is because this is empty, it doesn't have any weight to it, so it tends to scoot and move around. So I flip this way, and I use what God gave me, okay? I use my gut, and I put it this way, so that way if it moves, it's going to shift and come to me and stop, okay? And you unfold this way. Make sure you have enough overage that's even on both sides, okay? So that's typically how you do it, and you tuck it in. Any questions on that?
No,
sir. So that's for the big guy. We're going to be using 5-inch today. So when you're using smaller ones, you can get a lot of these covered all at once if you just use a bigger piece of dough. What you want to look for when you're measuring is, do I have enough leverage to go all the way to the bottom? So you lift up to see, and that's where you need to be making your cuts. So now I know I need about a lift of about, what is that, 2 inches all the way around in order to account for the depth of my pan. We want a little bit of overage on the outside edge. We don't want to take it just to the edge. You want about anywhere from a half inch to an inch hanging off the edge, okay? So in this case, I'm just going to use the fork because the dough is nice and soft, but this should be plenty of dough, okay? So for this, since it's so small, I can probably just manage it with my hands, okay? I'm going to place this into the pie pan. Make sure that you exaggerate and you gather it in there. You don't want to pull and stretch, okay? What am I doing here? I'm feeling around the bottom edge to see that it's actually making good contact with that corner, okay? You can't have it sitting on top like this. You want it flush, okay? So I'm feeling around. Once I know that it's making good contact, then I allow the natural overhang to occur. And don't bother with trimming yet, okay? What I'm now doing is I'm just going around with my fingers and feeling to see, did it shift, did it move? I'm wanting it to attach to the pie pan. So I'm just gently pressing to make sure I've got it touching the bottom as well as the sides and the bottom edge and corner. Now I have some decent overhang here that I can use my scissors. You're going to need your scissors, I forgot, to cut off the trim. This much trim, if y'all can see, is perfect, okay? This is a little much, okay? This is going to be too much. So you want to trim it back again, so that's about half an inch, okay? Anywhere in half an inch, 3/4 of an inch of trim. Does somebody have scissors out? So you go back in and you're going to trim all that excess. Now, I can take my scraps, and it doesn't have to be perfect, guys, okay? I can take my scraps and fold them into a new piece of dough. So all these scraps I can use with the next piece of dough I pull out of the fridge and help to kind of avoid the tough chewiness. Because if you just re-roll scraps all together and to make another pie, that pie crust is going to be not as good as the others. But I could probably marry it into some new dough and hide the fact that I have scraps in there. And the cold chilled dough will help with this dough that's already started to soften up quite a bit. Okay? So that's how I hide it. Or I use all my scrap dough to make fried pies. Top it with my lattice work. Okay. Now, if you're doing a, if you're not doing a double crust, then you're gonna use this overage for making your flutes. So let me show you how to make a flute. You're gonna